The two brothers involved in the Jussie Smollett case have released a new statement. Chicago police have accused Smollett of staging an attack against himself in Streeterville in January. He turned himself into police last Thursday and was charged with one felony count of disorderly conduct. Prosecutors say he paid two brothers, Ola and Abel Asendero, to carry out that fake attack. Last night, the brother's attorney released a statement saying, "My clients have tremendous regret over their involvement in this situation, and they understand how it has impacted people across the nation, particularly minority communities, and especially those who have been victims of hate crimes themselves."
Last week, Chicago Police Superintendent Eddie Johnson spoke to the media after Smollett turned himself into police.
Here is a portion of that emotional press conference.
"Why would anyone, especially an African-American man, use the symbolism of a noose to make false accusations? So I'm offended by what's happened, and I'm also angry. I love the city of Chicago and the Chicago Police Department, warts and all. But this publicity stunt was a scar that Chicago didn't earn and certainly didn't deserve."
Superintendent Eddie Johnson joins us now live from WGN Radio. Superintendent Johnson, good morning. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
That was kind of an unusual news conference for its length, its emotion, its seemingly condemnation of the suspect. Why did you feel the need to do all that?
Because, listen, we've made a lot of progress in this city. And, you know, I've lived in this city my entire life, raised my children here. And we do amazing things in this city. And I don't want anything to take away from that.
Do you regret any of the details you gave out? Now, there have been details about the $3,500 check, and there's been reports that possibly that check was going toward training rather than pay the brothers for this attack. Do you feel like you talk too much about the details of what the police know?
No, I mean, the facts are the facts. You know, those things aren't going to change. But what I'll say about the check is this. You know, if I were going to buy a kilo of cocaine, I wouldn't put in the memo section for a kilo of cocaine, you know, so I'm not concerned about that at all. And, you know, I also put out there that he still enjoys the presumption of innocence, so when the day and time comes, he'll get his opportunity to tell his version of events.
Now, you said that this case was not given any special treatment, that the resources used for this hate crime are the same that they're used for any hate crime, and that may well be, but I think the criticism really was, do you devote these kind of resources to murders and shootings?
Yeah, absolutely we do. You know, nothing was taken away from violent crimes. And again, you know, the resources we utilized for this hate crime was the ones that we would normally utilize. But the difference is we found out that this wasn't what it was alleged to be. So we have to treat everyone as victims until we have a reason not to.
Have there been any new developments in the case since you last spoke to the press?
No, there's nothing new going on. So now, you know, again, he and his legal team will discuss their options, of course, and he still enjoys the presumption of innocence until he gets his day in court.
Does, after you've been through all this, I think both the media and the police both saw issues with this case from the beginning, but you can't go with, you can only go with what you know, right?
Which is
what you did. But looking back, is there anything that you've learned from the handling of a situation like this that maybe you would do differently or?
No, because listen, our job as police officers is to investigate the crime, gather the evidence, gather the facts, and present them to the state's attorney, who then makes a determination on whether or not to charge the person. So the things that we did in this particular case, this is how we operate all the time. So we wouldn't do anything differently.
So the city of Chicago, unfortunately, still has this reputation of being very violent, and there's parts of the city that people are still very worried about things, but there is a bit of good news for February, yes?
Yes. So February had a 40% reduction in murders compared to last year, but overall right now we're 44% down in terms of murders compared to last year, 24% down in overall shootings, but also We have a 20-year low in robberies, burglaries, and motor vehicle thefts. And I think those are things that show that we're trending in the right direction. So now the challenge is to sustain it. But this city is getting safer. So I think that's something that we should all be encouraged by. We're not where we want to be, but we're certainly heading in the right direction.